I made a better version of the magnetic gearbox I previously built and tested on some issues such as torque, heating, or efficiency. And since I don't want to bore you, let's start directly with the torque test. And by the way, this is the previous design with almost no torque. Okay, that was so easy. 2.5 kilos. I made a long lever so I can turn it by hand. That is 7.2 Nm and the rotors still haven't slipped. And it's way more than my previous design. And the first thing I did for this was to arrange the magnets in a Halbach array, rather than alternating north and south. But before that, magnetic gearboxes consist of not two, but three concentric rotors, unlike electric motors. Yet, its operation is quite similar. So as the ring gear rotates, the magnetic field produced by the magnets on it also rotates at the same speed and direction. Adding the flux modulator made of steel poles dramatically alters this magnetic field. So now, as the ring gear rotates, it spins faster and in the opposite direction. The magnetic gear is completed by the addition of a sine gear that can engage directly with the modulated field. And in such a concept, magnetic forces play a key role in the slip torque. So I went from the alternating to the Halbach array to increase the magnetic field in the ring gear, which allowed us to benefit from the leaky magnetic fields by eliminating the need for back iron. For this, I basically offset the north poles of the magnets by 90 degrees, resulting in almost all of the magnetic field being directed inward. And look, now this side shows almost no magnetic properties at all, while the other side. But for some reasons, I used alternating array on the sine gear instead of Halbach array, and let's see how far it will go.
2.5 kilos. 3.5 kilos. 4. Oh, decreasing. Oh, it's gonna break. Slipped.
That means 15.2 Nm. As you can see, it's much more powerful now. And by the way, I mentioned that I used alternating array on the sine gear instead of Halbach array. But if we arrange it in Halbach array, the slip torque could increase even further. But before that, now I'm gonna really push the gearbox and try to heat up the magnets, and to avoid causing any permanent damage, I installed temperature sensors in two different points on the gearbox, directly touching the magnets, and one on the motor. Because as the magnets heat up, they slowly start to lose their magnetism. And once they exceed a certain temperature, it no longer sticks, and permanently loses its magnetism. And this is an electromagnetic brake, by the way, I made before. It has a custom-made electromagnet and steel brake disc, which were made for my previous projects on PCBWay. Also, various plex parts, steel sheets, all were really good. So when it's powered, the brake disc slides on the orange hub and sticks to the electromagnet, creating a magnetic lock, thus loading the output shaft, and we read it from the scale. Moreover, PCBWay offers a wide range of 3D printing, laser cutting, CNC milling, lathes, and even injection molding. For all this, just upload the design and sit back. I mean, that's all I did. And the most important part, PCBs. And there are so many different types that you can handle all your stuff on this issue. So I started the test, but I could only run the gearbox for 2 minutes. Because the motor overheated. And fortunately, there was no noticeable temperature increase in the magnets. And the reason for the motor overheating was that the load was too much for it. So I changed the motor, increasing the load, and ran it for 10 minutes. But when there was still no change in temperatures, this time I doubled the battery and increased the torque load to 4.5 Nm, which is a considerable load. And in fact, it's as much torque as the motor I use in the lathe. I run it for another 10 minutes, and at the end of a total of 20 minutes, I think the only issue was with the brake. The magnets in the ring gear heated up very slightly and went up to 25 degrees, while the motor was around 45 degrees. However, due to friction, the steel disc and magnet heated up incredibly. So, no heating issues, I guess. As a matter of fact, there should be, because when a permanent magnet passes near a conductive material, it changes the magnetic field within that conductor. And in such a concept, a consequence of this is the formation of eddy currents, which will cause heating. And as you imagine, a bunch of demagnetized magnets. Unless you make the conductive poles laminated. So I used transformer core material for the steel poles. My intention was to stack them on top of each other, just like an electric motor's core. This is because it's not only magnetically efficient, but also very thin, which minimizes the eddy current, and already insulated on the surface, which makes it difficult for the eddy current to pass from one to another. To demonstrate this, I just cut the aluminum into thin slices and isolated them from each other, and that's why the magnets didn't heat up. But you know, I'm not saying there is no eddy current anymore, just at the lowest possible level, similar to an electric motor. So I first cut them all into small pieces, then for sufficient durability, drilled through each one at the center and attached them one by one onto a 3D printed end cap using carbon fiber rods. But you know, the pieces are extremely small, so I first made a template from aluminum using my 3018 CNC, which wasn't easy at all. Then I put the pieces into the pocket and drilled on the lathe. So I made 17 steel poles, each with PLA support, which means about 1000 tiny steel pieces with a hole in the center. It was quite long and tedious, but you know, that's the only way to prevent overheating, which overheating is probably the only way to destroy this gearbox. By the way, it may seem odd having 17 of them, which explains the odd gear ratio of 5.67. And the reason for this oddity is to minimize cogging torque. You can easily feel cogging torque in any motor with permanent magnets. When you turn the rotor by hand, it feels like it's sticking. You feel the torque opposing your motion. And this is especially noticeable at low speeds, resembling a jerky operation, but it decreases as you accelerate. And in my initial design, I hadn't paid much attention to this, and despite the very low slip torque, I felt like I was overcoming all the opposing torque while turning it. And in this design, when I did a simple cogging test, the cogging torque was only 0.1 Nm, which is less than 1% of the slip torque, despite the powerful magnets used. After the gears were done, I made the shafts from aluminum, as it is lightweight and easy to machine, which allows the rotors to run almost touching each other. I secured the sun gear to the shaft through a keyway, which can withstand high torques and makes it easy to remove and install. The modulator shaft is made of thicker aluminum, as it will rotate with 5.67 times higher torque than the sun gear. And instead of a keyway, it was secured to the hub with 6 bolts. Yes, 6, not 12. I just missed the alignment. And since I couldn't support these shafts from both ends, like in most mechanical gearboxes, I simply nested them inside each other. Then I placed the sun gear into the modulator cage with the help of the lathe. By tightening the modulator supports with a 3D printed clamp, I securely attached the other end cap, completing the modulator sun gear subassembly. Even now, it's quite powerful and rotating perfectly thanks to the machined shafts. The final step is to place the subassembly into the ring gear. By the way, I made aluminum covers for the bearings. And these are essential because at high speeds, the bearings heat up and distort the 3D printed housings, which would completely ruin the ring gear. And this is the cover I made for the output. First, I attached the ring gear to the lathe using a 3D printed adapter, had to remove the cross slide, attached the subassembly to the tail stack, placed the sun gear shaft into the 3D printed adapter serving as a guide, locked the tail stack, and slowly pushed the subassembly into the ring gear. By the way, this gearbox allows for multiple gear ratios. My preferred 5.67 gear ratio, the rotors rotating in the same direction. If I keep the modulator fixed, the rotors rotate in the opposite direction, and the gear ratio is always one less than the previous case. There is one last thing, but look what I just noticed. I'm gonna give it a sudden load. Yes, there is something rubbing inside, which is why I took it apart in a slightly risky way and noticed some scratches on some magnets, which is clearly caused by the modulator. So I made the modulator perfectly smooth and clean, and while I was at it, I also replaced the sine gear with the Halbach array one. And the reason why I didn't initially go with the Halbach array was the complex rotor geometry. Because the only way to arrange the 18 magnets on the sine gear in a Halbach array to make 3 pole pairs is to arrange them in groups of 6. This means each magnet would be rotated with a 60 degree offset. And now, firstly, there is no sound at all. But unfortunately, there is still a clicking noise I couldn't eliminate when I mounted it to the test rig. And let's see if there will be any change at the torque.
Ooh.
My first attempt with the Halbach sine gear ended up with a bit of overload. I then repeated the test 3 times with a longer torque arm. And the slip torque of the gearbox increased by 42% to 21.6 Nm, which is solely due to the change in from the alternating to the Halbach array. So it has 21.6 Nm slip torque, and it seems to transfer it smoothly without heating up, at least up to 5 Nm. Now the question is, how efficient is it? And this requires the mechanical powers at the input and output shafts. So I mounted the motor freely, and I measured the torque on the input shaft from the reaction torque of the motor. As for the output, there is already an electromagnetic brake, and input and output speeds are also recorded. When looking at the powers in the shafts, the efficiency comes out to be around 85%. This means that under these conditions, the gearbox results in a 15% power loss for the torque conversion. And this is about the same as the previous axial flux one and a 3D printed mechanical gearbox. And I believe there's a slight error in the results due to frictions. Moreover, during the process, the efficiency went over 100% because the motor overheated.